BALSAM is an 8-voice modal synthesizer, which allows you to pitch bend and manipulate each voice individually using this array of sliders. It was inspired by the pedal steel guitar, which uses pedals and levers to do this pitch bend action, and also by classic 70s and 80s polyphonic synths like the OB-8 and the CS-80, which were capable of really long polyphonic portamento times. So you could create these drifting chord progressions that kind of melt into each other over several seconds. It's a really cool sound that's probably most recognizable from Alice Coltrane's devotional recordings. So BALSAM's whole sound is based off of this very slow manipulation of timbre and pitch, which is why it's named after a very slowly dripping sap. Since BALSAM doesn't have a traditional piano-style keyboard, the tuning works a little bit differently. Each tuning consists of 8 notes played on these 8 keys. And 8 different pitch bends, which you can play on these sliders. You can also change the tunings by moving this encoder wheel. You can select between different tuning banks by pushing and selecting different keys. And you can transpose the entire tuning by pushing and turning. There's also an octave transpose. A pitch wheel. And a key latch. To the left of the tuning wheel, there are 3 different types of polyphonic glide available. There's classic portamento, which is what we've been listening to. It's also known as fixed rate, which is what you'd find on an OB-8. There's fixed time, which sounds a little more modern and forces all of the notes to arrive at the same time in any given chord. And there's fixed interval, where each voice card starts from a specific musical interval and glides into its target note. There's also a feature called viscosity, which is unique to BALSAM. Viscosity adds some slew limiting or drag to your pitch bend movements. So when you have no viscosity, pitch bend happens exactly as you move the slider. But if you add more and more viscosity, the oscillators start to move more slowly toward their target. This is very cool when you combine it with this pitch invert toggle, which bends all the notes at the same time. Another unique feature of Balsam is that oscillator 1 and oscillator 2 can have their own speeds for these two effects. So if you're playing with glide or viscosity, both of the oscillators can move at completely different speeds toward their target note. This can create anything from a very subtle thickening of the voice card sound, to very dramatic phase interference type sounds and beating effects where the two notes are slightly out of tune and kind of phasing against each other. See if I can get something like that dialed in. Sounds like that. Most keyboard synths use an arpeggiator or a step sequencer as the clocked component. Balsam has another reimagining of that classic architecture, which is this polyrhythm sequencer. It allows you to cycle notes on and off at some subdivision of the clock, and then manipulate that subdivision by moving these sliders around. Create all kinds of cross rhythms and polyrhythms and hemiolas and various patterns using this sequencer. And you can easily manipulate any of the parameters as you're playing. Currently we're in a quantized mode, so all of the subdivisions are quantized to the clock. But you can also unquantize the subdivisions and slow the clock way down and create very slow evolving drones and tempora style effects with the sequencer. I really like this sound because it reminds me of a digital Schruti box. There are a lot of other features that we didn't get into in this video, so if you like features, here is a list. Thanks so much for watching this video. Balsam has been in development for several years now, and I'm really happy with where it ended up and everything it's capable of. I'm going to be shipping out the first handful of units early in 2026, so if you're interested in getting on a waitlist for that, you can do it at glx.ltd.